Cats from far and wide are irresistibly drawn to a seemingly insignificant plant.
If you're having trouble deciding what kind of feline friend to have in your home, we've got you covered. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 domesticated cat breeds. For this list, we ranked cats based on their behavior, body type, responsibility levels, how good they are around people other than their owners, and their popularity among the people adopting them. Now grab some catnip and let's meet some kitties.
Its aromatic oils make them frisky and playful.
Number 10, Bengal. This type of cat may not be the best on this list in terms of cuddling, but it's still a very adoring breed that loves attention. Bengal cats are extremely smart and athletic felines. Generally, they're pretty gentle creatures and are inherently domestic cats, despite their rather wild-looking spots and leopard-like bone structure.
Don't knock that over either. Nope, leave that alone. Nope.
If you're inclined to take your cat out for walks on a leash, this may be the breed for you.
Their activity level dictates that you have an active family.
Number 9, Oriental short hair and long hair. One of the cat breeds that's similar to dogs in terms of behavior, this type of kitty is also similar to the Siamese cat. How so? Orientals can be very social and demanding felines, though they're definitely more quiet and reserved than the Siamese, who they're related to, by the way. But what separates the Oriental from their puss peers is that they're available in more than 300 different color combinations and come in both long hair and short hair form.
They're just so much fun. They bring so much joy and love to our home.
Number 8, Burman. Likely originating from Burma, where they're believed to have been the protector of temples in the country, these cats are very playful, which is a good thing if you have kids or other pets around. But they're also good at keeping themselves busy.
Oh my God.
That said, they're usually fine with guests at your house, and they're flexible creatures as well, which are traits you don't usually expect from other breeds of cats. On top of all that, you don't have to groom them much either.
What'd you say?
Number 7, Sphinx.
Look what you did to Mr. Bigglesworth!
But Dr. Evil, we were unable to anticipate feline complications due to the reanimation process.
Silence!
You may tend to more commonly associate this breed with Mr. Bigglesworth from Austin Powers, but this cat is definitely more than just a movie star.
They kind of feel like a warm suede hot water bottle.
They're almost hairless, and their unconditional love towards their owners, as well as their love for cuddling, makes them well worth owning.
I give up, you guys. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this thing.
Baking it didn't help, huh?
Its sensitivity is what really makes it a domesticated cat, but it's also quite good around strangers and doesn't like being alone for too long. So, maybe you should consider getting 2 Sphinxes. Number 6, Abyssinian. Friendly, lively, and very attractive. What more could you want from a cat breed? Thin and slender in their body type, and very elegant looking. The Abyssinian is one of the more active breeds of cats, known for how much they love to play games whenever they get the chance. Not only are they extremely active and intelligent felines, they're also great around kids. So young parents looking for a feline friend to join their family might want to consider having one of these around their home. Number 5, Ragdoll. Named as such because of how they go all floppy when you hold them in your arms, this breed is a very affectionate and loving one, both towards its owners and towards children. However, this is very literally a domestic cat, as ragdolls are not particularly good at defending themselves. That said, they are loyal cats, in the sense that they'll follow you around wherever you go. So much so that they might remind you of a dog.
They're very affectionate, and they'd probably be a really good first-time cat.
Number 4, Siamese.
We are Siamese, if you please.
from the fact that they crave routine, this breed can sometimes be accused of being demanding of their owners and craving attention. But otherwise, the Siamese are cats who will give you all kinds of love and affection.
Where are your toys? Downstairs? Pee downstairs?
With their highly social and athletic demeanor, they might not be the most convenient kind to have if you're not home that often. But at their best, they're one of the most loyal types of feline friends to have.
Siamese have an interesting coloration because they're partially albino. So when they're born, they're white and then develop the coloration.
Number 3, exotic short hair. A bit like a short-haired Persian cat, more on the long-haired kind of Persian later, but maybe even more loyal and friendly, exotic short hairs are also very good cuddle partners. These cats are sometimes known as the lazy man's Persian because their coats are easier to care for.
Every day if you take a little Q-tip, cotton ball, and you clean out those wrinkles, your cat's gonna be a lot healthier and a lot happier.
They're laid back and chilled out felines, but can still be energetic when they wanna be. If you want the best of both worlds, in other words, owning a Persian without having to groom them so much, the exotic short hairs are right up your alley. Number 2, Maine Coon.
They are the largest of the American long-haired cats. They come in about 75 different color combinations.
With their flowing coat, various colors, and strong bone structure, these cats are great ones to have at home. They do well in winter with heavy snowfall, since their fur and big paws make them very durable in those kinds of weather conditions. Native to the state of Maine in the United States, they are large, weighing up to 18 pounds on average, but also gentle creatures that may have a thick coat. But they don't need to be groomed often, which is all the more reason to consider owning one. Before we unveil our top pick, here are some honorable mentions.
They're supposed to have a large, round head with eyes that are round on the bottom and oval on the top.
The main characteristic of the Manx cat is its taillessness, and the taillessness is what nature gave us. So the cats on the Isle of Man are without tails.
Hallo, Mollilein. Dass ihr so schöne Töne gehabt.
Number 1, Persian.
They're very laid back and easygoing. You know, they follow you around almost like a dog.
Their long fur, wide eyes, and pudgy faces bring their cuteness up to insane levels. And their gentle but colorful nature makes them ideal domestic pets. Though the early Persian cats are believed to have originated in the 1600s, in the region that would eventually become Iran, the more modern ones may have come from Western Europe. Either way, these cats are loving, relaxed, and make fantastic companions. The only downside, they are fairly high maintenance cats, in that their thick, long fur needs to be groomed every day.
If you don't comb them every day, they get mats. Some people actually opt to clip the cat down completely and give them what's called a lion trim. Well, make sure you go to a groomer that's really skilled with working with cats, because cats have very thin skin.
And they need to take baths often. But with these kitties, it's well worth all that trouble.
Let's go.
Do you agree with our list? What's your favorite cat breed of all time? With new and perfect top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.